Hello guys, hello, hello, hello. Welcome back. If you don't know, my name is Karen. Gosh, I feel like I've said this so many times, but we're still gonna say it again. I have decided to read all 13 books on the International Booker Longlist before the shortlist is announced on April 7th. I've read 6 of the books so far, working my way through the rest of them. It's a lot, I know. Please send me good vibes and speedy reading times. Today, we're gonna be talking about Heaven by Mieko Kawakami. This book is unsettling. It is crazy. The briefest summary of this book is that it is about a 14-year-old boy who is getting bullied horribly. It is bad. And he enters into a friendship with a female student who's also getting bullied. Okay, that's that. Now let's talk about the book. Let's go deep. The violence, the bullying, to even call it bullying just seems like it's violent. It's abusive. It is so bad. It is really uncomfortable. That's just like a warning. I didn't expect it to be that bad. And I was really tense while reading this book. The main character, whose name I don't really remember, I don't know, maybe it wasn't even mentioned. He's a really shy, introverted kid who has a lazy eye. And that is kind of what he thinks is the reason he gets bullied, because he's a little bit different and all of his classmates call him Eyes. He becomes friends with this girl, Kojima. And she is a girl who is an outsider because she is dirty. She's because she misses her father for whatever reasons, decides to cosplay as being poor. This novel is very philosophical, but pared down. It's told, you know, these are 14-year-old kids speaking to each other, so the language is very simple and it's easy to understand. But at times it can feel a little like, okay, let's get to the point. Let's move things along. That's my only real complaint with the novel, is that sometimes it felt like we were introduced to things or certain details and we didn't see that follow through. I think we could have shortened things up a little bit. What's happening in this novel is actually what's interesting. We have the protagonist who is incredibly passive. All of these things are happening to him, and he becomes friends with Kojima, and her experience with the bullying that they're facing turns her into a fanatic. That was fascinating. She sees signs in things. She is her belief in their suffering is so strong. She thinks that she's almost becoming closer to God as a result of it, that because of their suffering, she is above these people. She says things like, they don't understand. They don't know what they're doing. It's very like biblical and, you know, almost like this Catholic idea of to suffer brings you closer to God. She then, as the novel progresses, becomes a bit of a fasting girl and stops eating. And there are moments where the narrator is like, when I looked into her eyes, she had this other world. Like, the line is, her eyes were blank. She was smiling perfectly at something beyond me. So her devotion to her suffering and to like doing these things to her body, but also experiencing all of the external abuse, is one that puts her closer to God in her eyes. And then the narrator kind of meets, what has a one-on-one with one of his antagonists. And that guy, whose name I forget, I think it starts with an M, he doesn't indulge the protagonist in pity, and he's kind of just like, if you wanted to, you can make this stop, but for whatever reason, you won't, and that's why we pick on you. We don't pick on you because you're a lazy eye. We pick on you because we can. The protagonist hears this and tries to like verbally argue back, but is struggling. Now, obviously, our narrator is shocked when he hears his bully, one of his bullies, kind of tell him that he feels no guilt or remorse for what's what he's experiencing. He's just doing it for fun. As the narrator reflects about this, he is able to see the bully's side, you know, kind of like objectively. He's like, I can see the logic there and what's happening. But as things progress in this novel and the crescendo builds and the tension is going up and up, oh boy, the narrator really has to sit with and grapple with what does it mean to be passive in the face of brutality and violence. Okay, that's all I'm gonna say. The novel is a lot. It is very intense and it's good for sure. I would recommend it to most people, but it could have been a little shorter. Just a little. Okay. Yeah. Have you read it? If you have, let me know your thoughts in the comments. And happy reading. Good luck out there. Let me know where you're at in the Booker process. And I will see you guys later with another video.